Welcome to Statistics Made Simple. I am Savita Valsan, and in this video, I'll discuss the properties of the binomial distribution with certain examples. I'll give you a recap of the binomial distribution. The binomial distribution is a discrete theoretical distribution whose BMF is given by P of x equal to ncx, p to the power x, q to the power n minus x, where x takes values 0, 1, 2, so on, up to n, 0 otherwise. The binomial distribution has two parameters, n and p, where n is the number of trials or the number of times the random experiment is conducted, and p is the probability of success. I'll now discuss the properties of the binomial distribution. This is a very important topic where I'll be discussing about 15 properties, and wherever required, I'll give you examples so that you can understand the properties better. Please learn all these properties well, as they can be asked as a one marker, two marker, and are applied in 5 mark and 10 mark questions as well. The first property is the mean of the binomial distribution is E of x equal to NP. Second, the variance of the binomial distribution is V of x equal to NPQ, where Q is equal to 1 minus P. Third, the standard deviation of the binomial distribution is SD of x equal to root NPQ, where Q is equal to 1 minus P. Please note here that the square root covers N, P and Q. The fourth one is another important property of the binomial distribution. So, a question can be asked for which distribution is the mean greater than the variance. So, your answer can be either the Bernoulli distribution or the binomial distribution. So, the fourth property we see that the mean is greater than the variance for the binomial distribution. Below, I am illustrating it with an example. Let us assume that n is equal to 5. What is n? N stands for the number of times the experiment is conducted, or it stands for the number of trials. And I'll also assume that p is equal to 0.4. What is small p? It is a probability of success. And when you choose a value of p, it should always lie between 0 and 1. Then you calculate Q, which is 1 minus P, which is 1 minus 0.4, which is 0.6. Now use the formula E of X is equal to NP. When you substitute the values, you get E of X as 2. Similarly, you write the formula for V of X, which is equal to NPQ. Substituting, we get the variance as 1.2. So what you observe in this example is that 2 is greater than 1.2. In other words, it means that the mean is greater than the variance. The fifth property of the binomial distribution states that when p is equal to half or 0.5, the binomial distribution is symmetric. That is, beta 1 is equal to 0. In the first year syllabus, we have learnt the topic about skewness. So before we define skewness, let's recollect what is symmetric. A distribution is said to be a symmetric one if the area on both the tails of the curve are equal. And a measure for symmetry is beta 1. So for a symmetric distribution, the area on both the tails of the curve are equal, and beta 1, will be equal to 0, whereas skewness means lack of symmetry, and under this we have learnt a positively skewed distribution and a negatively skewed distribution. For a positively skewed distribution, beta 1 will be greater than 0, and for a negatively skewed distribution, beta 1 will be less than 0. So keeping these aspects in mind, I will explain the fifth property using an example. But this example is only for you to understand the fifth property, and you don't have to learn it from the examination point of view. So in the example, let's assume n is equal to 6 and p is equal to 0.5, which means that q equal to 1 minus p is also 0.5. Starting with the PMF, we know that p of x is equal to ncx, p to the power x, q to the power n minus x, and the range is x is equal to 0, 1, 2 up to n. Now substitute n as 6, p as 0.5, and q also as 0.5, which results in the PMF as p of x equal to 6cx, 0.5 to the power x, 0.5 to the power 6 minus x, where x takes the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now below you see a table which comprises of two columns. The first column is x and the second column is p of x. So in the x column, write down the values from 0, 1, 2 up to 6. Now in the second column you have p of x, which are the probabilities of x. How is this column obtained? So in the PMF, substitute first x as 0 and simplify. You get the probability as 0.0156. Similarly, in the PMF, wherever you have x, replace it by 1 and simplify, which will result in 0.0938. Repeat this procedure for x equal to 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, which will result in the probabilities as 0.2344, 0.3125, 0.2344, 0.0938 and 0.0156. So once we obtain the probabilities for different values of x ranging from 0 to 6, next we will draw the graph which you see beside the table. Now how did I obtain this graph? On the x-axis, take the values of x, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And on the y-axis, take p of x. Now the scale which I have taken for the y-axis starts from 0, then 0.05, and the last value which you see is 0.35. Now I have chosen only two places after the decimal for the probability so that plotting will be easier. Now corresponding to x equal to 0, plot 0.01. Then similarly, when x takes a value 1, mark the corresponding probability as 0.09. When x is equal to 2, plot the probability as 0.23. When x is equal to 3, the corresponding probability you plot as 0.31. When x is equal to 4, plot the probability as 0.23. When x is equal to 5, you plot the probability as 0.09. And when x is equal to 6, plot the probability as 0.01. Now from this graph, you obtain or you see that the center line is x equal to 3, and on either sides of x equal to 3, you see that the shape is symmetric. So in other words, it means that only when p is equal to half or when p is equal to 0.5, the binomial distribution is symmetric, and for such a distribution, beta 1 is equal to 0. Moving on to the sixth property of the binomial distribution, when p is less than half or 0.5, in other words, q is greater than half, the binomial distribution is positively skewed, and for such a distribution, beta 1 is greater than 0. A positively skewed distribution means that the right tail is longer than the left tail of the curve. The seventh property is if p is greater than half or 0.5, that means q is less than half, then the binomial distribution is negatively skewed, that is, its measure beta 1 will be less than 0. In a negatively skewed distribution, the left tail of the curve will be longer than the right tail. So keep in mind that only when p is equal to half or 0.5, the distribution is symmetric. If p is less than half, the binomial distribution is positively skewed, and if p is greater than half, then the binomial distribution is negatively skewed. Now the eighth property states that if np is an integer, then the mean and mode are equal. So what is an integer? It is a number without the decimal point. The ninth property, the mode of the binomial distribution is equal to the value of x which has the highest probability. So the mean and mode of the binomial distribution are equal only if np is an integer. Now suppose np is not an integer, then the mode of the binomial distribution is the value of x which has the highest probability. For this, let's take an example which you see in the table. Consider the following probability distribution. When the first row you have the x values as 0, 1, 2, p of x values are 0.25, 0.5, 0.25. So when we add up all the probabilities, the sum of the probabilities should be equal to 1. Now here, the highest probability in the table is 0.5 and the corresponding value of x is 1. So in other words, it means that the mode of the distribution is 1. In the 10th property, I'll discuss the probability distribution of a binomial variate x. We are aware that a probability distribution is a table which comprises of two rows. In the first row, you have the x values, and in the second row, you have the corresponding probabilities. So let's see how to obtain the probabilities for x taking the values 0, 1, 2 up to n. So for that, let's see the calculations as shown on the slide. I'll be starting first with the PMF of the binomial distribution, which is p of x equal to ncx, p to the power x, q to the power n minus x. And you know that the range is x equal to 0, 1, 2, and it takes a finite number of values, that is up to n. Now first step is put x equal to 0 in the PMF. So you'll get p of 0 is equal to nc0, p to the power 0, q to the power n minus 0. So which is equal to nc0 will be 1. You can try it out in the calculator. For example, 4c0, 6c0, any number c0 will always be equal to 1. Then similarly, p to the power 0 is 1, and you will get q to the power n. So when you simplify, you'll get P of 0 is equal to Q to the power n. Now put x equal to 1, which results in P of 1 equal to nc1, P to the power 1, Q to the power n minus 1, which is equal to n into P, Q to the power n minus 1. Similarly, put x equal to 2, which results in P of 2 equal to nc2, P to the power 2, Q to the power n minus 2. Proceed in this manner and put the last value of x as n, which gives us P of n equal to ncn, P to the power n, Q to the power n minus n, which is equal to any number c, that same number will always be 1. You can try it out in the calculator. 10c10 will be equal to 1. So it's 1 into P to the power n, Q to the power 0. Any number to the power 0 is 1. And on simplification, you get P of n is equal to P to the power n. Now all you have to do is form a table where in the first row you have the x values as 0, 1, 2, so on till n. And in the second row, you write P of x, then substitute the corresponding probabilities, which are q to the power n, n p q to the power n minus 1, n c 2 p square q to the power n minus 2, so on p to the power n. The 11th and 12th properties of the binomial distribution are important 2-mark questions from the examination point of view. So now let's discuss, when does the binomial distribution tend to the Poisson distribution? So there are 3 conditions under which this happens. The first one is when the number of trials is very large. The number of trials, you know, it is denoted by n. Very large means it is infinity, but infinity is an imaginary value which cannot be attained. So in other words, when we say the number of trials is very large, we write it in terms of notations as n tends to. Tends to is replaced by the right-sided arrow and then we write infinity. So n tends to infinity means that the number of trials or the number of times you conduct the random experiment is very large. The second condition is when the probability of success is very small. You know that the probability of success is denoted by P, and very small means the value is 0. So when the probability of success is very small, it can be written in terms of notations as P tends to 0. And the third condition is when lambda is equal to NP. Later, you will see that lambda is the parameter of the Poisson distribution and it's also the mean of the Poisson distribution, and NP, you already know, it is the mean of the binomial distribution. So when these 3 conditions are satisfied, that is when n tends to infinity, p tends to 0, and when lambda is equal to np, which is a finite value, the binomial distribution tends to the Poisson distribution. Similarly, in the 12th property, we'll discuss how the binomial distribution tends to the normal distribution. Again, the normal distribution is a topic which will be discussed later on, and it falls in the category of continuous theoretical distributions. So now, what are the 2 conditions under which binomial tends to the normal distribution? The first one is when the number of trials is very large, that means n tends to infinity. And the second condition is P and Q are almost equal. And what are P and Q? They are the probabilities of success and the probability of failure. So when n tends to infinity and p and q are almost equal, then the binomial distribution tends to the normal distribution. Now, before we discuss the last three properties of the binomial distribution, let's learn what do we mean by a recurrence relation. So a recurrence relation is a sort of equation that will define a sequence based on a rule that gives us the next term as a function of the previous term. You will see the application of the following recurrence relations in the problems which will follow in my next video. So moving on to the 13th property, the recurrence relation between successive probabilities is given by the expression, which you have to remember, is P of x equal to n minus x plus 1 by x into P by q, P of x minus 1. 14th is the formulae for the theoretical frequency or the expected frequency. So a theoretical frequency is denoted by Tx, which is equal to capital N into P of x. Please observe that here x is a subscript for T and N stands for the total frequency. The 15th property and the last one is the recurrence relation between successive frequencies, which is given by Tx equal to N minus x plus 1 by x into P by q, Tx minus 1. So there is a sort of similarity between the 13th and the 15th formulae. The only difference is instead of P of x, you have Tx, and n minus x plus 1 by x, P by q remain the same. And instead of P of x minus 1, you have Tx minus 1. So when you have the recurrence relation between successive probabilities, the formula is in terms of probabilities. Whereas when you have the recurrence relation between successive frequencies, then the formula is in terms of frequencies, which are denoted by Tx and Tx minus 1. Now all these 15 properties which I have discussed, I would like to again remind you that they are very important and can be asked as one markers, two markers, can be used in 5-mark problems as well as in 10-mark problems. You don't have to know the examples for each of these properties. The examples which I have given are only for your understanding. So please practice all these 15 properties of the binomial distribution so that you'll be prepared to work out problems on the binomial distribution, which I'll start in my next video. Thank you.